we actually go through a kind of a voting. In the process, we have a yes and a no, but I think it's not going to quite work this time because you've got quite a sort of a range of different
scattering
of pins across. So what I thought would be better to do would be table by table to get a summary of the discussion and if there were any really strong ideas, maybe even the blue ideas, which are the new ideas. So let's get a discussion on what the table thought were the good uses of tools.
But also we'd like to encourage the feedback from everyone else as well. So obviously on the supporters table, the actual supporters are now spread across the other tables as well. So maybe if the respective tables would like to explain what the discussion was and what they've done, and then we'd really like to hear feedback from
them. So we start on our table. So actually we got to a discussion about the use of tools and also how that actually sits with face-to-face. There was quite a strong comment about, there's almost a fear of running away, running before you can walk, and it's all very well technology, but what's really missing the whole process, fundamental risk for neighbourhood planning is we still need new tools and means to actually post level dialogue and talk to each other and explain ourselves. Language came up. It came up in terms of professional language to the layperson's understanding, which happens a number of places in the process. But also there was a comment about, well, language as a straight, different languages of people's understanding in certain neighbourhoods. So were there any good tools for that? And I don't know if anyone wants to add some of their ideas from, we have the usual discussions about going to find places where people already were, if there were communities on which had strong presences in existing blogs and websites. Does anyone want to add any of their thoughts? Can I read out a couple of blues? So we have a blue tool, if I can read it. Use of structured dialogue, methodology, techniques. So I guess that was on the earlier. Use of arts-based creative techniques. Bridging techies and bringing techies and communities together. So actually that to me says, well, look, we need to find new communities which are dedicated to bringing those different communities and bridging that gap.
I'd really like to add to that. I think that's really powerful because one of the obsessions with the Arts Council and everything around techie stuff at the moment is where's the content? People are obsessed with content because if you get good content that's relevant, then you've got an app, you've got a product, etc., etc. And actually, when we've been experimenting with that, it's been really successful because what it's done is that we all work in our own maps around silos, around our chosen expertises. And once you start bouncing in a creative way with a community group or whatever about their needs, suddenly you can see the glass ceilings moving for everybody. So, it's really quite interesting.
And what's interesting about the neighbourhood planning potential, if everyone knows what it is, you look around you, you'll find many neighbourhoods, maybe not in all, but many neighbourhoods, you will find the skills that you need.